In this video, we're going to look at the different types of cervical vertebrae. Here's a typical cervical vertebrae. And you can see here that we know it's a cervical vertebrae because it has the three holes, right? The transverse foramina, one on either side, and then the vertebral foramen through which the spinal cord passes. So this is a cervical vertebrae. But there are two special cervical vertebrae that are named C1 and C2. C1 is most superior and C2 is then inferior to that. And C1 is also known as the atlas. And I'm just gonna look at the atlas first. So to orient ourselves, this is anterior and posterior. And these are lateral. And again, you can see those transverse foramina still, so we know this is a cervical vertebrae. But you'll notice what this cervical vertebrae is missing is the body, right? It doesn't have that sort of body that supports the weight. So this is C1, also known as the atlas. It's so named because it supports the weight of the head, much like the mythical creature Atlas supported the weight of the world on his shoulders. So these parts here articulate or form a joint with the occipital condyles at the base of the skull, and that articulation enables the head to move in a nodding fashion, front and back, sort of like if I was nodding yes to you. So again, this is C1, the atlas. You will need to know both those terms, so C1, cervical vertebrae 1, and the atlas. And then the atlas articulates with the very next one, C2, like this. And it forms a joint between the atlas and C2, which is called the axis. So let me just look at the axis separately. So again, anterior towards the front, posterior towards the back. Again, you have a small spinous process and our transverse foramina, marking this as a cervical vertebrae. But you'll notice that it actually has a little protrusion coming out of the body of the vertebrae. This is called the dens. And the dens is sort of like the body of C1. So this is called C2, and it's also called the axis, and it enables axial rotation of the head. And so if you take C1, the atlas, and put it on C2 like that, then you can see that that joint, that protrusion, that dens, will enable the head to rotate on its axis, much like the earth rotates on its axis, okay, to give us a day. And then that enables what we sometimes call the no movement, shaking your head left to right like you're telling someone no. So these are three cervical vertebrae that you can see here. And again, here you have the atlas, C1, and the axis, C2, with the dens.